Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are almost set for this game between New South Wales and Japan. Jono Farr and Nicholas Kuniak in commentary. Great job on the last game between Victoria and the Queenslanders. What a fantastic result that was in the end.
What a game to watch there, John. I really enjoyed it, the way Victoria were able to win the game at the end. They were down, remember, by 4 points earlier on in the game, and they came back. But this one should be quite interesting. New South Wales and Japan about ready to do battle.
So here we go. We've got Daisuke Ikazaki in the black and the red in the seven jumper, and Riley Batt in the three. Pushed away nicely by Ikazaki. He takes control. Straight up, so the goal's coming very quickly within the first 6 seconds of the game. So Japan strike early, and it's one zip to Japan as Edmondson gives it in nicely to Bartlett. Bartlett just pushing his way through some traffic, tries to give it to Edmondson. Edmondson, beautiful pass to Riley Batt. He goes over the half, gets around Shimakawa. Nice work from Riley Batt. That's classy stuff from Riley, the Australian stealer. Terrific stuff from him. And it's one apiece.
Simon, go back! Simon, go back! Go back, Simon!
So the ball comes across nicely, and Japan will take it. Haga goes quite hard at the line, pushes away one. Beautiful ball back to Shinakawa. Shimakawa now. Kirahashi causing some problems with Holti, and the ball will go in for the goal. So Japan, they get the points on that occasion. 2-1. Nicholas Kuniak, will bring you in here firstly. How do you see the pace of this game so far?
Good start, isn't it, by both sides. New South Wales on the charge once again. End-to-end stuff so far in this one.
Edmondson passes it nicely to Batt. Batt just has the ball, plays it beautifully around the key, pushes around. Brilliant stuff from Daniel Holt in protection. Riley still on the charge. Kirahashi giving some issues there in defence. Ikazaki now pushing his way through. But the points go to the Gladiators as Riley Batt gets another try. And it looks like there's a bit of an equipment change or a problem there for Japan. It'll be Shimakawa that is the man in question. But he's okay now as he gives the ball back into Haga. Haga has it well. Back to Ikazaki. Daisuke Ikazaki. Plays the ball down the flank. Beautiful ball across. Nice team goal for the Japanese. And Shimakawa, Shinichi Shimakawa, scores the points on that occasion. So the ball comes back in to Bartlett, now to Edmondson. Edmondson just plays his way through it nicely. Straight up the middle. Good contest so far. 3-2 to Japan at the moment. 6.5 gone in this contest. Now it's played well beautifully by Riley Batt, who barrages his way through. Great intensity so far, Nick, in this one.
It is indeed. You're not wrong, Joe. Been a great game to watch. The way New South Wales are able to get back after Japan always getting that lead goal, so to speak. But they go up the middle once again.
So Ikazaki now has the ball in possession. Gives it across nicely to Shimakawa. Beautiful overhead pass. Can he connect with Haga? He can. Terrific goal from Japan. Wonderful stuff. They really connected beautifully on that play. Ball back in from Bartlett, now to Batt. Batt takes it up the middle. Beautiful blocking from Daniel Holt. Now Riley Batt over the attacking half. Tries to go himself. Bang straight into Ikazaki. Now Riley Batt going just outside the key. Will slow it down. Daniel Holt and Edmondson will work well in protection here. They go right side. Riley Batt goes straight up the middle. Beautiful blocking from Daniel Holt. He creates a hole. And Batt goes through. Terrific stuff for the Gladiators. Wow, they're really turning it on here. So Japan now on the attack. Overhead pass, long ball. And Ikazaki now will have the chance there and pick up the try. So what intensity we're seeing so far, Nick. This is fantastic to watch here.
It's been great end-to-end, and hopefully New South Wales can get back into this one. This left-hand side getting the pass back to Batt.
So Batt will have possession now. It's 5-4 in favour of Japan. Takes it up the middle, Riley Batt. A powerful young fella, turns 28 this year. And a great goal there for the Australian representative. So now Haga will have possession from the line. We pass over to Ikazaki. Ikazaki now just floating around the fringes. Has Haga there just in front of him. Provides a good block. There's been a push there. Riley Batt is claiming something there. And the ball will go to the sideline. And it'll be possession for Japan. So Haga will have the ball from the sideline. Nice push pass into Ikazaki. Good floating pass over the top to Haga. Haga goes hard into Bartlett. Haga now inside the attacking quarter. Beautiful work from Ikazaki as a floater. He somehow gets the ball open to open court. Picked up now Shimakawa. Shinichi Shimakawa goes hard at bat. Somehow manages his balance. Gets it to Haga. What a goal. Terrific stuff, Nicholas Gunyak.
Fantastic the way he was able to just stay up and got the pass away. Fantastic work by Japan. But here come New South Wales again. Trying to go up the centre here.
So now Bartlett, he tries to get possession. In fact, that's Edmondson. So Edmondson will give it to Bat. Bat plays it nicely. Bartlett just playing the key role up front. Bat nicely moves around. Haga, beautiful work from Daniel Holt. Now Riley Bat goes hard at the line. Brilliant work in blocking from Bartlett. And the points come the way of New South Wales. We're 6 apiece, 4.5 to go before quarter time. Ball goes over the top. Ikazaki now tries to take on the line. Long, long pass across the top. Beautiful work. Shimakawa will go in for the points. And Japan get the lead back just by the one at the moment. So this will be interesting to see which way this goes. These two teams, Nick, you would have missed it last year, but they battled it out for the final for gold at the Netball Centre, 59-58, a thrilling contest.
Yeah, but you can see the way both sides play. It's been a tough game. Bat getting himself involved.
Nice work from Edmondson. Edmondson trying to work his way through some traffic. He's got a two-man attack in Haga and Ikazaki. Beautifully worked from Edmondson. Still got the ball. He somehow got the pass across to Bartlett. Will Bat score? No. He will have a crack and just balance himself back. Holt blocking beautifully. Tries to take on Kirahashi. And the referee, Lloyd White, blows the whistle. So there'll be a sub here. So some fresh players coming on. It looks like Ben Ledé will be coming on for the Gladiators. So it'll be interesting to see who will come off for New South Wales. It'll be Simon Bartlett, and it looks as though it'll be Shimakawa that spends some time in the box. So they're down to three, Japan. So this will be a great chance for New South Wales to get that advantage, that four-on-three attack. Might give them a chance to get back in this contest and draw level. They need some points here. Riley Bat working his way on the out. Just on the key. Holty working well in defence. Great work from Daniel Holt, the big Dallas Cowboys fan. And Riley Bat takes his time and scores points. So play it well. And now we'll go back to the start. So the ball goes across. Ikazaki, you can hear the words of Curtis Palmer in the background. He's the coach of New South Wales, just directing traffic as Ikazaki gives the ball across to Haga. Haga goes at the line. Brilliant blocking from Riley Bat. Terrific stuff, Nick.
Great defence. Holding on nicely, New South Wales. 3:29 remaining in the first quarter. New South Wales fans, come on, let's hear it. And Japan fans.
Team Japan, who's here for the Japanese? So great representation of their fan group right across the 4 days here at Sydney Olympic Park Sports Centre. Of course, tomorrow is the last day that we're here, and then of course we move and migrate to the new Netball Centre for the final day, the big gold medal day. Of course, tomorrow's a gold medal day as well for the national championship. And we get back to live action now. And it'll be 7-all at the moment with 3:19 to go. So this has been a terrific game so far. Lloyd White, referee, with the ball. He'll give it to Masayuki Haga. And Haga will just play it short of the line. He'll give it into Ikazaki. Ikazaki just looking for some options. Plays it just pretty calmly, goes back to the key and puts the points on the board. So Japan regain the lead. Interesting to see what New South Wales do here, Nick.
Yeah, it will be interesting. You're not wrong, Jono. I don't know if you try to get Bat out wider here or do you put the go down that left side, the go down the left.
So they'll play it nicely. Edmondson has the ball for the Gladiators. Tries to get the pass away. Brilliant pass there to Riley Batt. He's done brilliantly. Can Ben Ledé pick it up? No. Just out of reach. Great work in the end there to Kurahashi. She was brilliant in defence there, preventing that play. So unfortunately, the points didn't come the way of the Gladiators. As Ikazaki now has the possession. Goes Hail Mary pass, long court to Shimakawa. And Shinichi Shimakawa will go through for the points. So Curtis Palmer just giving some instructions to his team. He's got his own personal training business, Curtis. And he was recently a new dad, so it's been a big year for Curtis Palmer, the coach of the New South Wales Gladiators. Former player as well. So he's done it all in the sport. Wonderful to see him doing so well as Riley Batt picks up the points there. And that gets us within one there. 9 points to eight, just over 2.5 to go in this quarter. Ikazaki now plays possession. Goes inside the attacking quarter. Tries to look for some opportunities. He's got Riley Batt in front of him. Goes long ball court. Finds Shimakawa. Nice pick up from Shinichi Shimakawa. And he gets the points on that occasion. So we'll come back to the key. How do you see this game going so far, Nick?
Just both sides still feeling each other out at the moment, Jono. That's the key of this game. So what New South Wales can do now on the counter.
So Edmondson will have possession. Gives it to Batt. Batt in open pasture. Shimakawa's there. Kurahashi tries to stop him. She can't. And he can score points. So we go back to the start. Nice pass across to Ikazaki. Ikazaki goes long ball court. Can Shimakawa pick it up? He can! Oh, how about that? Brilliant stuff from Japan. The pickup was a beauty. A bit David Mead-like for the Gold Coast Titans.
It was a nice pick up at the end, Jono. And a great effort by Japan. New South Wales now on the attack once more. A great work by Japan to initially get the steal, but referee calling it back.
So Edmondson had possession of the ball. Shimakawa tried to get clever, but unfortunately not the case. So a big loss here for Japan as Ikazaki goes some time in the box. So they're down again to three. This will be a huge, huge thing. So they're down to three now, Japan. Kurahashi, Shimakawa and Haga. And New South Wales, they've got the four on the court. So the ball goes up court for Riley Batt. He'll play it nicely. And the points come the way of the Gladiators. So that gets them a bit closer now. 142. Just the 1 point margin. 11-10. Japan leading it narrowly. Nice pass across court. Plays it well to Shimakawa. Shimakawa now battles beautifully through the middle court. Around Edmondson. Beautiful pass to Ikazaki. Ikazaki will slow down the clock. 29 seconds on the shot clock. Moves in pretty well. And he'll get the points on that particular occasion. So Japan just going further in front. 12-10 now. 2 points the margin. Edmondson has possession of the ball. Nice pass over the top. Finds Riley Batt. Batt works his way through some traffic around Shimakawa. Tries to get around Shimakawa. Now Daisuke Ikazaki gets in there. And the ball comes across to Edmondson. Edmondson plays the ball. Nicely played to Batt. Batt goes up the middle and gets the points. Terrific team goal, Nick.
Yeah, great team goal by New South Wales. Using the team quite nicely. Now it's time Japan to get back in the attack. 12-11 to score.
Ikazaki has the ball, looking for someone to throw it to. Fires it down court, finds Shimakawa. Shimakawa, beautiful defensive work from Haga. And Shimakawa goes down. So huge big battle across. Collision there from players. And Edmondson will find himself in the box for some time there. Sort of came across and sort of took out the man, just sort of working in defence, but Shimakawa was sort of on an interesting sort of curve when he was taking the ball, so it sort of upended him. He's okay, he's back on two wheels now, which is good. And the play will continue in just a moment. So this is day two of the Fierce Four Rugby Championships, all thanks to GIO. Wonderful to have their support right across the 4 days and for the last couple of years, I should say. as Harger gives the ball in possession. Wonderful to see members of the military here, the Defence Force. Thank you for your support as well. As Ikazaki now has possession, tries to battle his way around the key. Nice little pass over the top. Beautiful stuff from Shimakawa. So Japan really starting to gap them a little bit here. How do you see it, Nick?
Well, you're not wrong, Jono. With time ticking this first quarter, we need to see Bat go forward. He's doing it right now.
Good pass across court finds Edmondson. So Bat and Edmondson combine beautifully. And we're now 13-12, so back to one. This has been a terrific contest so far. Keep in mind, these two teams battled for gold last year at the Netball Centre, and it was a one-point victory to Japan, 59-58. So we're going in similar territory right across the three quarters. We're all square until that final result. So it could go this way, maybe into overtime. Ball comes across to Ikazaki now. Daisuke Ikazaki playing it well, nicely around the key. He's got Edmondson to get past. Does particularly well, needs to go support, but he'll go straight up the middle. Beautifully blocked by Riley Batt. Daniel Holt tries to stop possession. And no points there on that occasion.
Safety.
So the Gladiators will call a safety call, and it'll be interesting to see how they play it here. So they're down by one, 13-12. Long, long pass, Riley Batt. Can't find anyone. And it goes out of bounds. So that is quarter time in this wonderful clash between Japan and the GIO New South Wales Gladiators. At quarter time, Japan lead it narrowly, 13 points to 12. We'll be back in a moment. So here we go. Welcome back to this clash between Japan and New South Wales. A replay of last year's final. First time these two sides have battled since that contest. So away goes Riley Batt. Nicely played away. And he'll get back in the game. So New South Wales square at level 13 apiece. This is a terrific contest we're seeing, Nicholas Kuniak.
Well, good job there by Batt. New South Wales really need to be better in this quarter. Japan had the best as they called a timeout here. Good time to call a timeout as well. So 7:50 remaining here in the second quarter. New South Wales and Japan doing battle. And as I said before, we need to see the other guys stand up for this New South Wales side. Batt's doing a fantastic job, but the others really need to get involved. And also, the big question is, when do you bring on Harry Clist, who played well yesterday in that first game? Do you bring him on in that fourth quarter, or do you bring him on early? That's the big question. I know he's young, but...
Yeah, look, he's an emerging player, and this will be a terrific challenge for Harry. So, I mean, he worked so well in that final quarter against Queensland in their 20-point victory yesterday.
Yep.
So, yeah, I would bring him on in that final term, maybe late in the third term as well. But we shall see how Curtis Palmer decides to go there. As Ikazaki now has possession, and he takes it up half court. Played pretty well.
Here we go.
And good possession there, so the goal comes away. So it goes to 14-13 now, Japan leading it narrowly. So it'll be interesting to see what New South Wales have got here. There's been a timeout called. Curtis has called it for the Gladiators. So they'll come back in. Holti, Bat, Edmondson and Ladei come in and have a bit of a chat with Curtis Palmer. He was a former player for the Gladiators, Curtis. And as I said, he's got that new personal training business up and running. So it's great to see him doing that. And of course, he became a father as well. So it's been a pretty busy couple of months for Curtis. And now he's taking over this role in the coaching position. Of course, Stephen Holt, a.k.a. Scooby, is in his swan song year. He's done some amazing and wonderful things for this sport. Great ambassador and a wonderful bloke. So we wish him all the best in his future endeavours. So the 2017 Nationals is his swan song. So let's hope the Gladiators can produce a medal for him. So played away nicely from Edmondson. Nicely played to Ladei. Ladei battling through some heavy traffic. Gets it beautifully away to Edmondson. He goes up the middle past Shimakawa. That's a classy play, Nick, from New South Wales and Andrew Edmondson.
Yeah, fantastic work there by Edmondson. The get over. And again, we see Japan on the attack. Great pass out.
Ikazaki gives it nicely to Shimakawa. And Shimakawa will play the ball beautifully. So possession goes the way of Japan. And they lead it now, 15-14. 7:20 to go before halftime. So the next game here today will be Team Canada v Victoria, which will be a wonderful clash. The first appearance of Canada today. Victoria going in their second clash. They had that victory over the Queenslanders that you called, Nick. Do you think it'll be a challenge for them against the Canadians?
It will be a tough game, that is for sure. It'll be a tough game between those two sides. By the way, I was just thinking before, Japan having that short turnaround break, it's going to be hard to come back third and fourth quarter when they start to get a little bit more tighter than the New South Wales side.
So Japan go hard at the line, and it's Ikazaki that gets the points. Riley Batt tried to block it out, but not on that occasion. So it comes now to New South Wales. And there's a stationary call, so the play will go back, and it'll be New South Wales through Edmondson that has possession. Tries to battle his way through. Gives it nicely to Bat. Bat just under some traffic, but good blocking from Daniel Holt. He pushes away one. Gives the ball back across to Ladei. Ladei goes hard at the line. Can't quite get the points on that occasion. He's just tipped over close to the line. Got a late shunt there.
Good defence there by Japan at the end. And with 6:42 remaining, a tight game between New South Wales and Japan. A scoreline of 17-15. And we can see, of course, as we look at the timeouts called for this afternoon so far, 2 for Japan, 1 for, 1 left, I should say, for New South Wales. So that's what it looks like here in this game between Victoria and New South Wales. In this one, I should say, it is 2-4, so Japan using 2 of those. New South Wales haven't yet. They've used 1 coach's call.
So it'll be Japan that play it now. Back to Ikazaki. Noramasu gave the pass across. Ikazaki pops the pass, and it's a loose possession. So this is a great opportunity here for the Gladiators to take possession. Ladei will have possession of it. 17-15, so they're down by 2. They need to turn this particular play into points. Let's see what they can come up with. Ball goes across to Bat. Bat plays it well. Nice pop over the pass. Can Edmondson get it? Yes, he can. Wow. Lightning reflexes from Andrew Edmondson. And the points come the way of the Gladiators. So they reduce the margin to 1, 17-16. 6.5 to go in this quarter. And this half of wheelchair rugby. We hope you're enjoying this contest. John O'Farr and Nicholas Kunyak in commentary. Shimakawa goes through for the points. And head to wheelchairrugby.com.au for all the live streaming, for all the tickets. If you want to come tomorrow and Saturday, go on to www.wheelchairrugby.com.au and click on the events page where the Nationals is, and you'll be able to get all the information that you need for today, tomorrow and Saturday, the remaining 2.5 days of the 2017 Fierce 4 Rugby Championships. Of course, all the games streamed live on the website, which is great to see. And you'll be able to stay in touch with all the results wherever you may find yourself in the world, Nick, which seems to be a bit of a regular thing for sport these days.
It's great, of course, and you can watch them on replay as well over the coming days, weeks and months. So enjoy what you seeing what you missed, as now Bat has possession for New South Wales.
So he'll play it nicely, tries to get around Shimakawa and does that beautifully. Pivoted his way around nicely, just around Ikazaki. Good blocking there from Edmondson. And Bat will get the points. So Norimatsu will start us again for Japan. Good pass in field to Ikazaki. Ikazaki goes Hail Mary, long pass to Shimakawa. Now he has Riley Bat to contend with. Shimakawa now has Andrew Edmondson. Norimatsu on the right. Norimatsu with some blocking. Gives a pass across court. Changes direction and Ikazaki gets the points. So Japan, they go back to that two-point lead. 19-17. Still a close contest, Nick.
It is a close contest. Both sides really pushing hard here. New South Wales on the return serve now over to half court.
Played well by Bat. Bat just pushing his way around Ikazaki. Good blocking there from Daniel Holt. Creates a big gap. And that's terrific stuff. So the Australian international leads the way one more time. Turns 28 this year, Riley Bat. He's been a wonderful representative in wheelchair rugby. He's appeared at a number of Paralympics. Four, in fact. Of course, Rio de Janeiro, he claimed gold against USA in a thrilling double overtime final. 59-58 was the score on that occasion. Very similar to the scoreline the last time these two sides battled it out. As Bat gives it to Edmondson. And the play is there for the Gladiators. So they go within just the one now, 20-19. So it's getting a little bit tense as we approach half time, Nick.
Expected between these two sides. Very tough sides, both New South Wales and Japan. As I said before, Japan playing early on today. It's a big challenge there by Bat. Great work by him.
So Riley Bat creates the turnover.
Great work, Riley. Oi, Edmo Riley.
Now,
Edmo Riley.
There'll be a change here.
We need one. Jump off.
So Edmo will just push back a little bit. So the play inbound goes to Riley Bat from Lede. Riley just holding court in that middle, working his way nicely. Edmondson creating a block, so too Lede, but it's Daniel Holt that does well close to the line that gives Riley Bat the opportunity to go through. It's really just those combinations close to the line that are giving New South Wales some real ability here.
You're not wrong there, Jono. Again, Japan on the break.
As Shimakawa goes through for the points, so they respond quickly, Japan. And I noticed that Kaya Kurahashi is back on the court, so it's wonderful to see so many great female representatives in this sport. Of course, Maya Ummeyer from New Zealand, Kristen Cameron from Canada. And, of course, the original queen of wheelchair rugby, as I nicknamed her, Robin Lambert-Walton. So, unfortunately, she has, for the sport's sake, she has left, and she's now going on to other sports. So it's wonderful to see her perform in different levels of Paralympic sport. So Robin was a wonderful addition for the Asteron West Coast Enforcers. And, unfortunately, they haven't been a part of the Nationals the last couple of years, as well as the Amy South Australian Sharks, as Riley Bat takes over, and the points come the way of the Gladiators. So, Nick, 4.5 to go. We're all square here, mate.
It's been a tight one, hasn't it? Japan really trying to push out. They haven't been able to. We talk about how vital it is for back-to-back points in this game. It's now Japan going forward.
So, well worked from Shimakawa, trying to battle through. Two-man player, manages to get the pass over the top. calm as you like to Ikazaki. And Daisuke Ikazaki breaks the deadlock. So 22-21 now, the score between Japan and New South Wales. We hope you're enjoying this contest. A replay of the 2016 final as Riley Back just takes it up the middle, tries to battle his way around Shimakawa. Does particularly well. Beautiful one pass, bounce pass to Edmondson. Edmondson now just calms it down. Gives it back to Bat. Bat close to the line. Pops over the top. Oh, they combine beautifully. And Edmondson gets the points.
Yeah, great job at the end there by New South Wales. The combinations are working well. And that's key for this New South Wales side. As now we see Japan trying to hoik it down this right side.
Norimatsu gives the pass across to Shimakawa. Under some traffic with Holt and Bat. Norimatsu now gets himself clear. Here comes Riley Bat and the collision is there. So bit of an unintentional collision there between Bat and Norimatsu. So Bat will just spend some time in the box on the sideline as Saya Norimatsu goes back up. So wonderful player. He debuted in 2013. A friend of his introduced him to the sport. He now represents the Okinawa Hurricanes. And he turns 27, Nick, in 2017.
Stats.
A wonderful player, Saya Norimatsu, for Japan. He was here last year for the Japanese and played a key role in the final in their victory and taking gold. So the players just getting themselves readjusted on court. And there'll be a couple of changes there for Japan. Haga's back on the court. Ikazaki retains his spot. Tomoki Amai will come on in the jumper number 9, and it looks like Kano on that far side. He's just coming onto court now from the sideline, Kazuhiko Kano. So they're the four for Japan, and the four for the Gladiators, Riley Back, Daniel Holt, Andrew Edmondson, and now Ben Luday, who has possession, who gives it back in court to Riley. Riley just pushes his way around nicely. Good possession play. Has Daisuke Ikazaki on his tail, but gives the pass beautifully to Edmondson. And Bat and Edmondson combined wonderfully. Great cross-court pass there, Nick.
It was great cross-court work there by the New South Wales side. Really plays some great football. I'm really enjoying the way both sides are playing. End-to-end stuff. Just need a control. Both sides need to somehow work on the control. It's now Japan. The game will just go up the middle. Bat was beaten.
Yeah, Ikazaki goes at the line. Edmondson tries to get him but can't. So now the score 24-23. So Japan back to that one-point lead with just over 3 and a bit to go before half-time. As Bat plays it nicely through the middle. Tries to battle his way through. Good stuff from Riley Bat, the Australian stealer. Goes hard at the line. He's got Kano on his tail, but he can't quite stop him, Kano. So it'll be Riley that gets the points on that occasion. Kano now, inbound ball, good pass across field. And they'll go hard at the line now. Nice little pass to Ikazaki. Ikazaki, overhead pass. Can it find Kano on a couple of bounces? But Riley Back comes through with a steal. That's what the Gladiators needed. They needed some mistakes from the Japanese side, and they respond brilliantly through Edmondson. That was terrific stuff from Riley Back on the chase, Nick.
Yeah, another great effort there by Bat on the chase, and New South Wales looking very good. Even Stevens once more in this one. It's been a great contest as Japan will go through for another.
So 25 apiece now as Haga gets the points. Masayuki Haga. He was born in 1985, which makes him 32. He's been in the side for 5 years, and he appeared in the Rio Games. And of course, the Japanese, they were beaten by Australia in the Rio Games, 63-57. Their third in international rankings below the USA, who lost to Australia in that double overtime final in Rio de Janeiro at the 2016 Paralympic Games. And after claiming gold in 2016 here at the Sydney Nationals, they're a big chance of getting another gold medal. They're undefeated at the moment in this tournament. They had wins yesterday against Victoria, and of course they defeated New Zealand earlier in the day, which was a wonderful contest. So wonderful to have them part of the Sydney Nationals. As Riley Back takes on the line, he has about a 3-man wall of defence that he's got to get through. Now he's battling close to the sideline. What will he do? Daniel Holt tries to create an opportunity and creates a gap for him. So well done, Holtie. Good pass over the top. Edmondson will pick it up and go for the points. So we go back to 25 apiece, and now it's 26-25. 2:19 to go. Good pass over the top. Played well by Ikazaki. Ikazaki just battles his way through. A couple of bounces. Nice pass. And they'll get the points on that occasion. So they'll play it well. And Ben Luday now has possession. Luday has possession, gives it nicely across to Edmondson. Edmondson just battles his way through up the middle. Takes on the defence. Good work from Daniel Holt just off the fringe. Plays it nicely, Edmo. Edmo battles now. He's got Haga there as well as Kanu. Tries to get it back to Bat. Now he does that. Ikazaki's giving Bat some trouble. Bat needs to get the pass away close to the line. Nice little pass. Ben Luday couldn't quite get it, and there'll be a change of possession. Ikazaki now picks it up. He's done particularly well to stay in there. And the points come the way of Japan. So 27-26, 90 seconds before half time. How do you see it going in these final 90 seconds, Nick?
Okay, Japan just take the lead back. They were really pushing hard. It's New South Wales get a nice pass on.
Edmondson has possession. And it'll come back there. So referee Lloyd and Quentin. So these two international referees, they've had plenty of experience at this level. Certainly a lot of experience at the national level. Lloyd, a Kiwi, Quentin, an Aussie. So a nice little trans-Tasman mix there between the umpires. And the play will continue through the Gladiators. So can they retain the lead here in these final 90 seconds? Riley Batt will just slow down the clock. 30 seconds left, just about that. Plays it well just on the key, slowing down the clock. Great international battle here. A lot of international flavour between the two here. Of course, Japan and some Australian representatives in Riley Batt and Andrew Edmondson. Played nicely away by Batt. He's got some work to do. Slows it down. You can hear the count in the background. Riley gets the point. So we're under a minute now. And we're at 27 apiece. So thrilling stuff here between these two sides. They're just pacing themselves nicely here, Nick, as we go into the final minute.
Yeah, New South Wales are trying to play down the clock. That occasion. But really been a fantastic game to watch. Japan really trying to push this New South Wales side, but New South Wales just won't give up. And now it's Japan again with possession.
So Japan will have it. Nice pass over the top. Kano in possession over the halfway line. Riley back tries to go for the steal. Put some pressure on. Edmondson's there as well. Pass goes back infield. Nice work to Haga. Haga, Masayuki Haga. Beautiful work around there. Gets around Riley back. Bat in the middle of Haga and Amai. Tomoki Amai battling well beautifully. But it's now Riley back just still bothering Haga. Masayuki Haga trying his best to get around a couple. Riley still in the middle. Tomoki Amai, the ball's come loose. Terrific stuff from the Gladiators. So applying the pressure there, and it seemed to go their way.
Did you not wrong there as the timeout's been called?
So that looks like there's a bit of a sub call. Sub call to Japan. So Ikazaki will come onto the court in the 7 jumper. And the 23 is Hitoshi Agawa. So a couple of changes there, two of them for Japan. Let's see if this makes a difference. And it looks like Kano will come off the court as well as Masayuki Haga. So losing two key players but gaining some different experience here, the Japanese. They've got a great rotation in this tournament. And a coach's timeout will take place. So just 12 seconds left in this contest. It's been great to watch so far, Nick.
Been very good to watch. You're not wrong, Jono. The way New South Wales are able to come back in this one, Bat's been the key player for the New South Wales side, and he's really been one of the keys for this. Let me say it properly. Gladiators. I'll say it nice and slowly.
I thought you were going to say gladiatorial.
Yes.
Right.
Yes, I was about to. but Edmondson also being a good player from Andrew Edmondson, him and Bat linking up well together. Just want to see how this second half will pan out. The way the changes will be made in the second half. The Japanese side, they're playing well, and they're just a tough side. They're a very tough side, and they don't panic. They just get the job done.
They certainly do. So, just a discussion between Lloyd White and the panel of experts on the table, the technical referees. Loves his chocolate milk, Lloyd White. Mr. First Class, some people call him. Bit of a tradition before each tournament, his famous chocolate milk from across the ditch. So we'll go back to the possession of play now. It'll be Toshi Ogawa that has possession in the 23. Nice little pass back in field. Shimakawa goes at the line, battles around Ikazaki. Ikazaki trying to stop Bat as well as Ogawa. Can't get it, and the play is there. So we're inside the final seconds here of this half. 28-27 to Japan. Edmondson can't quite get it away quick enough. So that's half-time here between the GIO New South Wales Gladiators and Team Japan. It's a thrilling contest at the moment. It's 28-27 Japan over New South Wales. Back in a moment. Okay, so here we go. Second half in this clash between Japan and New South Wales. A wonderful battle going on. 28-27 at the moment between these two sides. Japan just lead it narrowly. And Nick, what do the Gladiators need to do in this quarter to get themselves back in this contest?
Just really start playing as a team. Get that combination going. That's the big thing. Not just always thinking bat's going to be there. Use the other players on the team. We've got a very talented side across the side. And let's see what happens in this quarter. Now they go for once again. Good pass out by Japan.
Shimakawa gives it infield to Ikazaki. And the points go the way of Japan. So good start for them. They give that two-point lead back. Wonderful player, Daisuke Ikazaki. A bit of a veteran in this particular competition. Hokkaido native. He turns 39 this year, so a bit of a veteran in the sport for Japan. Plays it nicely to Bartlett, but Ikazaki gives some carry there. And it's just a bit of a push there, so it'll come back. And a timeout has been called. So it'll go back the way of the Gladiators. Bartlett now has possession. He gives it infield to Edmondson. Edmondson floats it nicely across, and Simon Bartlett on the charge. Recently got married, Simon. Terrific player for New South Wales. He's been in the playing group for a number of years now. Claimed a silver medal at the 2016 Nationals last year. Right, nice pass now from Japan. Mai gives the ball into Shimakawa. Shimakawa will play it close to the line. Has plenty of protection there. Nice work there from Ogawa in defence. The changeover comes the way. So nice little pressure play there, Nick, from both sides, really.
You're not wrong there, Jono. New South Wales will be able to get the ball back. And now let's see what they can do with the possession. It's back with it once more.
So Bat has the ball just in the defensive quarter now. Plays it nicely at the line. Just goes straight up the middle. And Japan, through Amai, tried to get him. Just ran out of a bit of space there, and it was just the pace of Riley Bat that picked it up. Nicely played away by Ikazaki. Ikazaki now still in possession, trying to get away from Riley Bat. Great blocking there from Daniel Holt. Ikazaki fires the pass over the top. Shimakawa threads the needle between Bartlett and Edmondson. And the points come the way of Japan. So 32-29 now the score. 6:52 left in this third quarter. Plays it nicely to Bat. Good pass from Edmondson. Bat up the middle. Flying down the flank now. Gives the ball back in field. And straight through the middle. Tries to find Amai and gets the try line instead. So that's the better result for the Gladiators.
Amai. I think so. I think that's the point of the game, Jono.
That's the goal. Pardon the pun. Ikazaki now plays the ball. Straight up the middle. Good work from Bartlett. Trying to put some pressure on Ikazaki. Edmondson tried to go at him but couldn't quite get it. But it was some blocking there from Shimakawa that prevented that. So the points go to Japan. 31-30 now. They lead it by one in this third quarter. Thrilling first half we saw between these two sides, Nick.
It has been. And this second half starting to be a bit of a seesawing affair. New South Wales really trying to go forward. Here's Bat once more.
Takes it up the left flank. Now moves across the middle and goes straight up. Past Shimakawa. And the points come for New South Wales. Another try. Ball nicely played infield. Shimakawa, overhead pass, finds Ikazaki. Couple of bounces to keep it alive. He'll slow down the clock here and go through the line. So 32-31, just over six to play. So nicely worked away from Edmondson. He'll fire the pass over the top. Riley Bat on the charge. Bat gets possession and gets the goal. So it'll be played there. So now Ogawa will have the ball. Gives it in field. Nicely worked. Shibakawa has possession. Straight up that left flank. Moves beautifully. Nice little pass over the top to Ikazaki. And that's the combinations we were talking about, Nick. And Japan certainly put on one there.
Again, they're just making the combinations work here. Hopefully they can keep it up. Good game on our hands here. 5 minutes 45 remaining in this quarter.
So Edmondson has possession straight up the middle. Gets rid of the pass and draws the man, Riley, back. Terrific work on that right flank. Goes over for the points. Curtis Palmer just giving some instructions to his team. Way it goes to Ikazaki. Nicely played from Shimakawa. And he'll play it there. So a great record from the Japanese coach in Kevin Orr. He's coached Japan, Canada and the United States. So the triple threat for Kevin. Wonderful to have him here as a part of the Japanese team. A journeyman in the sport. Nice pass over the top from back. Gives it to Edmondson. Edmondson plays it well. Goes close to the line. And Andrew Edmondson gets the points. Of course, he represented Australia at the recent Paralympic Games in Rio de Janeiro. Played well by Ikazaki now. Ikazaki straight up the middle. And he'll just get some more points as the referee blows the whistle. A Hokkaido native, Daisuke Ikazaki, his second year here at the Sydney Nationals. Edmondson has possession of the ball. Plays it nicely through the midcourt. Just working his way around Shimakawa, who tries to off-balance him. Shimakawa now battles there. Good pass away to Edmondson. Gives it to Bat. Bat just plays it back nicely. Tries to go at the line. Bat will just hold it up a little bit. Ikazaki has some issues there to work with now. Great work there to Bat. Bat up the middle, trying to go himself. Great work from Simon Bartlett in coverage, and it creates the opportunity and the try there for Riley Batnick.
He's looking good, isn't he? Bat really playing a great game for New South Wales. Tight one here, 35-35, 4:36 remains.
So the ball goes to Shimakawa. Came inbound from Tomoki Yamai. And there'll be a bit of a coach's paddle here. Timeout call for Japan. So it'll be New South Wales players just having a bit of a board meeting in Holt, Bartlett, Edmondson and Bat as the players go back on court. So there'll be a couple of subs here. Curtis Palmer just making some changes. Bartlett will come off the court by the looks of it. And Ben Luday looks like he's about to come on. So 11 off, 12 on. Bartlett off, Luday on. And Norimatsu, he's come on for Japan. And Shimakawa now has possession of the ball around Edmondson. Shimakawa tries to go at the line. Battles his way through nicely. Goes the dummy and gets the points. So 36-35, that regains the lead for Japan. About 4 minutes to go in this third period. So it's a referee's call from Lloyd White. And now we'll go back to Ben Luday, who has possession. Luday, nicely played away. Popped over the pass beautifully from Edmondson. Gives it nicely to Riley Bat. Bat gives it across to Luday. The Luday flying, so too Shimakawa. Luday battling well, needs to get that pass away. Riley wanting it. So players just discussing how many timeouts are left and the like, which is vital in this game. Luday is on the sideline and he'll get possession from referee Lloyd White in a second. And he'll inbound it. Nice pass to Edmondson. Don't think he was ready for that pass, but he certainly took it pretty well. Nice little popover pass to Riley Bat. Bat will just slow down the clock. Plays it nicely. Just really slowing it down. Daniel Holt just providing some protection. Pushing the Japanese back. He'll play it well there, Riley Bat, and the points come for New South Wales. So we're back level peg, 3:43 to go, Nick.
Smart work there by New South Wales to play down the clock, 3:43 remaining in this third quarter, the championship quarter. And it's been a tight one between these two sides. Japan and New South Wales doing battle in this one. As we Get a change of gear here, or gear change for New South Wales, but 36 all in this tight one here at the Sydney Olympic Park Sports Centre. Great precinct and big couple of days coming up. Looking forward to tomorrow, of course, the big grand final, or the national championship final, the gold medal match tomorrow night. But of course, the big one on Saturday, the big day, when we got fifth versus sixth, the bronze medal match, the celebrity game, and the gold medal game. Great day too at the Netball Centre.
Yeah, finals day, it's always a lot of fun, especially with the celebrity game on the Saturday. But there's going to be something fun as well on tomorrow at 6:30. It's family and friends getting a bit of night court time. So that'll be great to see them out on the court and just having a go in the chairs and getting a feel of the sport. So that'll be terrific. And the celebrity game, we've got people from Invictus, there's people from GIO, people from the Defence Force, a couple of dignitaries as well. So that'll be wonderful to see the celebrity involvement there, and always a great turnout. I know Matt Carews from GIO, Killer, as his nickname is. Mm-hmm. He's looking forward to it immensely. I think this is his third or fourth appearance in a celebrity game. So he's been a great supporter of wheelchair sports, along with GIO, who are not only the sponsors of the Gladiators, but the Nationals right across the Sydney part of the schedule. It's been a wonderful tournament to be a part of. And now Ikazaki plays the ball just short of the quarter. Goes into the line and Riley Batt will try and go after him, but he's got his mind on something else, so he'll allow that point to go through for Ikazaki. And it's 37-36 now. So the one-point advantage goes to Japan. Lede now has possession at the key. Gives it nicely across to Batt, who did particularly well in a very small amount of space. Works his way around nicely out of the key. Bounces a couple of times to keep the ball alive. Kurahashi tries to get it. There's been a tyre puncture there, I think, for Edmondson for New South Wales. So that prevented a bit of traffic there, and Kurahashi was really blocking going into that possession. So just a quick tyre change there for Edmondson. He'll try and battle with Shimakawa. So it goes across to Shimakawa from Norimatsu. Shimakawa now straight up the middle. Plenty of power, great size, and he has pace as well. So he'll move in and score points on that occasion. So Japan just starting to inch a little bit further in front. They're still leading by one, but the battle is certainly on, and we're in for an exciting final quarter here, Nick.
Yeah, just the way New South Wales have been able to hold out here. It's been a tight challenge. So again, Batt really going forward. This is great work by him.
So Riley goes through for the points, picks up the win. So next game on the schedule is Team Canada taking on Victoria. Of course, Victoria had that victory over the Queenslanders earlier in the piece. And Canada will make their first appearance on day two. Had a wonderful performance yesterday against New Zealand. That was a really staggered out long game. But Fabian Lavoie was one of the players that really impressed me in the Canadian side. So it'll be great to see how they go a bit later today against Victoria, who were playing some really great wheelchair rugby in 2017. And there's an equipment check call from Daisuke Ikazaki.
Yeah, the glass is being knocked off, and it's one of those very important things to note when you're playing an indoor sport. And I can tell you from experience where when the glasses hit the deck, the first thing you're going, I hope they don't crack in that. And lucky back the sportsmanship thing, stopping playing, giving him the glasses and getting back into the action.
So Norimatsu gives the ball back in field to Ikazaki. Well played to Shimakawa now. Oh, beautiful overhead pass over the top to Ikazaki. And the points come for Japan. So now they're starting to stretch it a little bit. 2 points the margin. Exciting final quarter coming up, but still two and a bit left in this. Nice work from Edmondson. plays well to Bat. Bat pushes over the top. Beautiful work there from Lede. Lede just battling nicely close to the line. Noramatsu giving him some grief. So too Ikazaki. Lede still just struggling to get the ball away, and the referees step in. So there's a sub call. So there's a call for Holti, who will come off, and Lede will come off. And it looks as though Dicky Voris in the six and Jake Howe is looking like he'll come on as well in the two. So Riley Bat just getting some more treatment on that chair. Bit of one of the wheels just in the front right section getting fixed up there. So great battle here between Japan and New South Wales. A replay of last year's gold medal game that went to double overtime. Thrilling contest, the bronze medal game, in fact, between Queensland and New Zealand. That went to overtime as well. So it was an extended afternoon. Great test for the vocal cords as a commentator. I think I just got there. So Voris has the ball now inbound for New South Wales. Fires the pass at Riley Bat. Bat trying his way to get around. Might struggle here. Oh, beautiful pass from Riley Bat. Beautiful pickup from Andrew Edmondson. He does well to get around Ikazaki. That's clever stuff from Andrew Edmondson and Riley Bat. They've combined beautifully there, Nick.
Great job by New South Wales playing some great rule chair rugby. But Japan once again on the rampage down the middle.
So Shimakawa battles his way nicely. Pushes back, and the points come the way of Japan very soon. He's just holding up that key. Playing it pretty well close to the line, really soaking up the time. 17 seconds on that shot clock, and he goes through. So just over 90 seconds before three-quarter time, and they go back to that two-point lead. Pass goes over from Voris to Edmondson to Bat. Bat trying his best to get through some traffic. Nice work from Riley. Good work through the middle. Pushes away Ikazaki. Still going Riley. Pushes back in through midcourt. Shimakawa. Big collision there. Riley Bat goes up the middle. And he'll get the points. Great work there from Riley to battle his way through. Individual brilliance from Riley. Plays it nicely from Ikazaki now. Ikazaki just pops the pass over the top. Gives it beautifully to Shimakawa. Shimakawa, big collision with Riley Bat. Bat tries to get a hand on the ball there. Voris now creating some opportunities. Ikazaki does well. Beautiful pass. Shimakawa! What a catch! What a goal! Terrific stuff. And he does a nice little turn as well. So he's got it all, Shinichi Shimakawa. Terrific stuff from Japan. Edmondson has the ball close to the line. Plays it well to Bat. Bat just getting himself through some traffic around Noramatsu. Daisuke Ikazaki gave some grief to Edmondson. Edmondson trying to block on Shimakawa. They go bang. And it's a nice play from Riley Bat. So we're inside the final minute here. 42-41. We've got a thrilling final term coming up. Noramatsu gives the pass inbound. Ikazaki goes long. Can they get it, Japan? Couple of bounces. Picks it up on the third. Shimakawa now just goes back, holds the line. Well played by Riley Bat. Just in defence this time. So plenty of versatility for the Australian representative. Nice pass over the top. Ikazaki now pushes away one. Just gets around Riley. Now slowing down the clock. You can hear the count. Riley close to the line. Still trying to get at the line. What can he do? And the point is there. So 43-41 now. New South Wales have the ball. Long, long pass. And that is three-quarter time here between this clash in Japan and New South Wales. Terrific game. We've got an exciting final term coming up. Stay with us. It's Japan 43, New South Wales 41. Back in a moment.
We'll be right back.
great to hear Jono's theme song.
Okay, so here we go back in the final term. And it's a great contest between Japan and New South Wales, 43-41. Just under eight to play in this contest. It's been a wonderful game so far. It's Riley Batt just plays the ball nicely, close to the line. Plays it away. Good work there from Edmondson, so to Voris. An attack. And now Riley Batt straight up the middle. Great protection from Dickie Voris. Terrific stuff from him. And now it'll come back for Japan as they fire the pass across to Shimakawa. Shimakawa finds some opportunities. Draws the player in and finds Ikazaki in open court. Ikazaki, the expert when it comes to slowing down the clock. And he does it perfectly there. Wonderful player, Daisuke Ikazaki. He's been in the sport for a number of years now, a veteran at 39. So now it'll come cross court. Played well by Riley Batt. He'll try and take it through that defensive quarter. Away out of the key, through the halfway line, and the call has been made there.
Let's go, lads, come on.
So a couple of subs will come on. Daniel Holt, the big Cowboys fan, he's about to come on, as well as Ben Ledet, just from the New South Wales bench. And it'll be interesting to see who comes from the court. So Voris will come off, and Jake Howe will come off. So two and six come off, Jake and Dickie, and on goes Ben and Daniel. Ben Ledet in 12 and Holtie in 9. Riley Batt there in 3, as well as Edmo over on that far side. So we go back to the middle of the court. Kurahashi now creating some opportunities there in defence as Haga will have possession of the ball in just a few moments. So coming up next, we've got a wonderful game between Team Canada and Victoria Protec Thunder. Myself, John O'Farr, and Emma Stewart will take you through all of that. Away it goes to Ikazaki. It's been a tire blow. And Ikazaki will go through for the points. Equipment change. I've got a feeling it's from Japan. Yes, so the tire change will take place there. So an interesting period in the game here, Nick. How do you see it going?
It's evenly poised. It's been a tight one. I know it's 45-42, but you can still see New South Wales getting back in for the win. I know Japan are a tough side. They defend their hearts out, but you can see New South Wales still got the opportunities. They'll restart things back here, and let's see what they can do with the pass back in.
Ledet gives it on nicely to Edmondson. Edmondson plays the ball. New South Wales have that propensity to score points pretty quickly. Plays it nicely through Riley Batt. Batt close to the line. His determination will get him there. The big fella goes over for another one. So we'll go back to the key. We'll start it through Haga. Haga fires the pass across. Beautifully picked up. Shimakawa. Shinichi Shimakawa around Ben Ledet. Nicely played. Here comes Andrew Edmondson. The cavalry is coming. Riley Batt and Shimakawa go bang close to the line. And Shimakawa wins the battle. So the score now, 46-43, just over 6.5 to play. Plays it nicely to Riley. Riley Batt just getting himself through a bit of traffic. Daisuke Ikazaki there causing a few headaches. Playing beautifully, Riley. Now past Haga, now past Shimakawa. The two heavyweights go toe-to-toe again. And it'll be played on. So Riley gets the points. Terrific collisions and the intensity lifting a little bit in this final term, Nick.
Well, that's what we're seeing at the moment here, Jono. Good game in contest. As Japan go down the middle, good effort once more.
So Shimakawa will play the ball close to the line past Riley. And Shinichi Shimakawa, he gets the points there. He debuted for Japan in 2001. He was their best rookie. And he's been at two Paralympics in Athens and in Beijing in 2004 and 2008. Wonderful player for Japan as some more points come the way of the Japanese. 48-44. Just under six to play in this contest. Coming up next, Canada and Victoria. Canada's first appearance on day two. And then they've got another game which will complete day two against Queensland. So battling against two sides that will really challenge them. I think the game against Victoria will be a ripper. That's coming up next. And this game poised at the moment with just under six to play. So it's now played away nicely through Ikazaki. He's lost possession there. Ball goes out of bounds. So if you miss any of today's games, you can always head online, www.wheelchairrugby.com.au. Click onto the event stream for the 2017 Fierce Four Nationals. And you'll be able to get all the ticket information for tomorrow, for Saturday. There's opportunities still available for preferred seating if you want. $10 per ticket for the adults. So go online and pick up a ticket for maybe Friday or the gold medal day Saturday. And of course, you can watch the live stream there, so you can see all the games for today, tomorrow and Saturday. And of course, there'll be replays on there at some point in the future. So wheelchairrugby.com.au. Make sure you log on for all your information when it comes to the Fierce Four Nationals. As Shimakawa goes just short of the key and picks up points. So now it'll be played back from Lede. Nicely played away. So Andrew Holloway now on the court in the 10. AJ goes up the middle of the court, trying to battle his way through. What's he got here? He goes the right side of Daisuke Ikazaki. Now back through the middle. He's got Daniel Holt on his left-hand side. Plays the flank. Can't quite get there. AJ bounces once, spins twice. Now he goes again. Lede's just blocking beautifully on Ikazaki. Andrew Holloway, now he's got possession. Tries to go past Shimakawa. Daniel Holt creates an opportunity. He's unlucky on missing a goal there.
Very unlucky there, Johnny. Should have went in. Not the case at the end. It's a five-point margin at the moment, Jono, so it's starting to get a little bit away from the GIO New South Wales Gladiators. Japan side looking slick in the latter stages of this low-scoring affair.
So they're undefeated in the tournament so far. They had wins yesterday against Victoria, and they had a win earlier in the day, today, against New Zealand. Andrew Holloway close to the line. What can he do? Needs to find some support. Tries to get the ball away. Does pretty well. Kurahashi's on the left. Haga's on the right. And the call has been made. So play on. Ikazaki will now get it across to Masayuki Haga. Haga will have possession of the ball and go for the points. So Japan bring up 50 points. 50 to 44 now. In this contest, as New South Wales battle back, and there'll be a referee call there. So a timeout called, number 11. So there'll be a sub call by the looks of it, which means some opportunity for a couple of players to come on and off the court as we go across to the far side of the court for play on. So Lede battling with Haga. The ball comes across. Nicely played with Holloway. Holloway on the charge. He's dangerous when he's got some pace. He gets past Haga. Brilliant stuff. Goes bang into Ikazaki. Straight through goes Holloway. Holloway now looking for possession. The Gladiators building something nicely here. Daniel Holt's doing particularly well. Just run out of time there. And the penalty goal will come. So there was an illegal movement there inside the key for Japan. And now it was 50-44 the score. Just over four to go as Haga responds well and plays it nicely. So an interesting pace of this game between Japan and New South Wales. So it'll be Lede that has possession on that key. Gives the ball nicely in court. Wouldn't quite get Holloway on that far fringe. The ball goes out of play. It'll just be a brief restart in a moment. So there's a sub, a couple of changes, a lot of changes for Japan. Tomoki Amai is on. Kano is on. And Kurahashi goes off. So it's Haga, Tomoki Amai, Ikazaki and Kazuhiko Kanu on for Japan, and there's a stack load of changes for New South Wales. Edmondson will stay on. Dickie Voris will go to the sideline and he'll come on in a second. Jake Howe is in the number two and young 13-year-old Harry Clist is on in the 15. He's got first possession. He scored 8 yesterday against Queensland. Can he go for another one here? Picking up possession. Nice work from Harry Clist. Keeps the ball alive. Has Edmondson. Beautiful work there. Nice work from Harry Clist. Gets the pass away to Edmondson. Edmondson inside the key. Looking dangerous here, the Gladiators. They've got Voris there. What will he do? Edmondson goes, tries to go backwards around to Kazaki. Great blocking from Voris. Beautiful pass over the top. Couldn't quite find Clist. And the pass and the chance goes begging. Ikazaki now has some battles with Andrew Edmondson. Tries to get out of it. And now Middles himself caught. Big collision there from Edmondson. And just inside the court half, runs out of time. So play will go back to the middle. It'll be a possession here to the Gladiators. Dickie Voris on the sideline. He'll play possession with this. Nice inbound pass to Edmondson. Edmondson tries to battle around. Hager does well. Finds Voris. Voris now in some space. He tries to go. Harry Clist calls for it. Wants it. Voris gives it back to Edmondson. Edmondson controls it. Nice blocking work from Jake Howe. Beautiful pass to Andrew Edmondson. What about the catch from Harry Clist? That was special.
He just got in too because Japan were defending very hard there. He may have not been able to get the spin right, but he did at the end. And here come Japan rolling forward.
Ikazaki, they move inside the attacking quarter. Beautiful pass across, and Masayuki Haga gets the points. Under 3 minutes to go, 51-46. The Blues, here they come back. New South Wales, the Gladiators. Good pass from Voris. Good work now from Edmondson. Edmondson battles his way around nicely. Tries to go Hail Mary. Can't quite get that pass because he's getting some problems from Ikazaki. Finds Jake Howe. Can't quite get it. Change over is Hager. Hager now has possession. Gives the ball across field. Nice work from Ikazaki now. And he battles across court. And straight up the middle goes Daisuke Ikazaki. Beautiful cross ball. It'll be a slowdown in play. And it'll be Kano that gets the point. So great little passage of play so far from both sides here, Nick.
Not wrong, Jono. The way both sides are playing at the moment, 2:20 or 2:33 remaining on the clock here. So tight one at the end, 53-46. You think Japan will hold this out, but New South Wales, they might be able to put on a late comeback here as they try to get the pass out.
Terrific catch from Voris, gives it into Howe. Howe gives it Edmondson. Edmondson volleyball style pass. Harry Clist on the charge. He's trying to beat Hager. This is a great battle for the 13-year-old.
Yes.
That is on the play of the day.
Yes.
Harry Clist battle Masayuki Hager.
Yes.
Fantastic stuff for the 13-year-old. Take a bow. Harry Clist, wow.
And you thought for a second the experience of the Japanese defender was going to be on, but no, he just cut on the inside. There was a great defensive effort for New South Wales too, and Harry Clist picks it up and he will score a fantastic try. 2:16 remains, Jono, and that's a good one, 53-47.
Yeah, 6 points the margin. Terrific stuff from Harry Clist. He took on the experience, as you said. Had the inside play and then just controlled himself well, showed all the experience. And that's wonderful stuff. That'll do so much for the confidence of young Harry Clist. As away go Japan, straight up the middle. Nicely played through Nakamachi. Nakamachi gives the ball across court and finds Kanu. So there's been a couple of changes to Kumiwashi in the 51, Tomoki Amai in the 9. The 24 is Shunya Nakamachi and Kazuhiko Kanu in the 6. As Edmondson charges up for the Gladiators in 14. Goes over the halfway line. Tries to battle around the 51 in Washi. Beautiful work there from Edmondson. Battling with Washi. Has Nakamachi there as well. Good work from Edmondson. Nice pass over the top. Here goes Harry Clist. Look at the confidence of this young kid. Battles well. Dickie Voris. Brilliant stuff, Harry Clist. Another great try to the young fella. And the Gladiators are turning it on. Starting to come back, but they still need to force the mistake. As the play goes, continues to Washi. Washi up the flank. Passes over the top. Finds Kanu. Kanu now tries to find some space. He'll go himself. And Kanu goes at the line. So a great challenge here for Harry Clist in defence and attack. There was some support there from Shinuya Nakamachi, but couldn't quite get that pass connecting. Nakamachi has possession of the ball now for Japan. So Shinuya Nakamachi plays for the... So Tohoku Stormers back home. And Kanu will get the points. He was born in the year of 1994, which makes him 23 this year. So one of the younger players in the Japanese side, as Edmondson will have possession of the ball. Nicely played there. Beautifully worked up the middle. Has Harry Clist in front of him. Edmo taking on the Japanese. Trying to battle through. Great blocking from Clist. And it allows the opportunity for Edmondson to get the points. So the margin goes back to 7 points. We're under a minute. Japan 56, New South Wales 49. Under a minute to play. Beautifully worked away there from Nakamachi, who has support. Needs it now. Nakamachi looking for someone. Edmondson and Voris. Good pass across field. Washi now has the ball. Japan battling hard. Goes across past Edmondson. Works his way around Dicky Voris. And the goal is there to Takumi Washi. He's only 20 years old and he plays for the Hokkaido Big Dippers. He's one of their key players back home in Japan in their strong competitive Japanese leagues. And a bit of a star to watch for future reference in wheelchair sports coming out of Japan. As Edmondson works it nicely up the court. Beautiful work over the halfway line. Pops the pass across. Harry Clist controls it beautifully. Gives himself space. And another goal there to Harry Clist. I think that's about 4 or 5 for the young fella, Nick. So played a well now to Washi. Washi has possession of the ball. Goes up midcourt. And just tries to battle his way through. Has Nakamachi on his flank. Probably won't need him on this occasion inside the final seconds of this one. And the points go the way of Japan. With barely time on the clock, it's 58-50 to Japan. They lead by 8. And Edmondson will round down the clock. And that is full time, ladies and gentlemen, in this thrilling clash between last year's 2016 finalists. The final score, it's a win for the team Japanese. 58 points to 50. And ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for this wonderful contest that we've seen here this afternoon. What a match of wheelchair rugby we've got.
Well, how good were Japan? And there's no doubt about it, they're the favourites. They are the favourites for the main event on Saturday evening. And you've just got the feeling they will be the ones taking out the early favourites anyway. New South Wales look good. I honestly think they look good come tomorrow night's national final. Them against Victoria, I think, will be the possibility. They